They're obsessed with viruses, diseases, anything that messes up their food supply.
Heals over in minutes. Most people don't even know they've been infected.
You can only see them face to face. No mirrors, no photos, no videos.
Did they tell you I was evil? It's what the church always says, Mike.
I get night terrors occasionally.
This is not psychological.
Are you sure?
How'd you find me?
You covered your tracks very well. Unless the lady might have given up.
Hi.
I'm Jacob. You spoke to my editor.
Michael said that Jack was on the run. People were trying to kill him.
You frightened of making a mistake?
No hesitating. Shoot first. No warnings. Why worry?
Where's Gary?
Fell sick, Father.
Any news on the allergy?
It's dust from the smoke, the incense.
Any chance of seeing those symptoms for myself?
Don't have to go. I've got a note.
Gary, I've spoken to your mother. There's been no doctor. I just want to know what has changed between us.
You can't force me.
No one's forcing you. What's wrong?
Leave me alone.
What have I done?
Get out!
Now listen, lad, you just calm down. This is getting out of hand. Look, all I want...
Don't touch me! Keep going!
Come on, darling, move it along. Are you listening? I'm not letting you skip breakfast again.
What's up?
Nothing. I just want privacy. I can have some privacy, can't I? You've got locks everywhere else.
He wants you to meet him at the Whittington. Mortuary.
What's happened?
It was a priest. You all right?
I'm fine.
Where's the Witchfinder General?
Did you know him?
Only by reputation.
This isn't one for us, is it?
The boy who did this had no history of violence.
How old?
12.
It's not unprecedented. I don't think we can assume there's been code 5 involved.
I'm assuming nothing. Until 6 weeks ago, he was talking about the priesthood. What else do you know can turn a child like that?
When I was 10, I wanted to be a gymnast.
But you didn't reach for the Stanley knife when you changed your mind.
Now, it's really important for Gary's own safety that we find him as soon as we can. So if any of you have got any ideas where he might have gone, places you might have played together, or might just hung out, really. Now, you won't be doing him any favours if you keep it to yourself. Because he's not thinking straight and he could end up hurting himself. Now, if you don't want to talk now, I understand, but there'll be a chance later on this morning, one-on-one. Okay? Thanks, lads.
People don't change overnight. Even kids don't.
You haven't had much dealing with them, have you? One day his butter wouldn't melt, the next they're setting fire to drunks.
Yeah.
No, I've seen it. I don't give a shit what kind of home he came from. Some of them turn into evil little bastards without any help at all. You know, we should have some better criteria for investigation.
So what about the kids in the classroom? You saw how they reacted to daylight.
Right, what about meningitis? It's very popular in schools. Affects the brain, makes bright light painful, triggers mood swings.
Very good. Maybe you should examine the children and I'll interview the parents.
Incidentally, photophobia is a fear of all bright lights, not just daylight. And meningitis presents over days, not weeks.
Uh-huh.
If it is, you better find him quickly.
Right.
Michael.
I'd rather it was. Really, I would. No one's leaping to conclusions here. Make sure you don't.
Well, nothing at all?
Nada.
Sorry, I'm new to this. How is this progress?
Your friend Michael has disappeared. He hasn't just moved house and job, he's covered up every track. I mean, I know I'm not a private investigator, but I do know how to find people. It's like he's been put under witness protection or something, you know? Cutting off from you is just the start. He's got a totally new life.
Well, what about his family?
Mm-mm. Tighter than a rat's ass.
So, it's good that we run into a brick wall.
Oh, yeah. It's confirmation. You know, whatever this squad is, it's got a lot of clout, probably government backing. We're not in paranoia land anymore. I thought it was for a while now. See, what we need now is a bit of luck. Someone's got to talk to us. It's just not his family, though.
What, past contacts, friends?
Old flames?
Yeah, I met the last one. I could give it a go. Maybe she's not still a complete bitch.
Hey, you can handle it.
Maxi Mark 3, meet Gary. Gary's got a day off school. Don't you give me the evil eye, I'll take you out later. Jesus. What do you drink? Beer?
Coke.
Make yourself at home. I've got some new games on the computer. Got the new Star Wars. It's not in the arcade yet. I used to skip school all the time, mate. Never did me any harm. Maxie!
Oh, Jesus!
Well, his father was the religious one. Not me. To be honest, I was a bit relieved Gary chucked it in. I went along with it, but I want him to grow up normal. Not a priest, for God's sake. He liked Father Downey. I can't believe it.
Gary didn't say why he stopped going, did he?
Well, Father Downey rang a couple of times to ask where he was, and Gary just said he got fed up with it. I thought the bullying had something to do with it. But he's at that age, isn't he? I didn't think much about it.
Was Gary ever violent towards you?
No. Never. Lately, he's been worse in the mornings. I mean, he gets angry when I try to get him out of bed. You know, pulling the curtains back. I don't know where he got that knife.
Did Gary make any new friends recently?
He doesn't bring friends here. I've said he can.
What about Father Downey? Did you see him outside school?
Choir practice, I suppose.
What's the name?
Dog's had his shots.
Hey!
What's he playing at?
Hello.
You can't do this. How can you do this?
Public health order.
On what grounds?
Contagion.
Oh, come on, you're joking.
They're presenting the symptoms.
Yeah, I've seen a priest knifed. They just stick a cross in their face, they're about to kick up.
Which hospital?
I thought you said this religious stuff was psychosomatic.
Daylight isn't. Once I've examined them under UV, we can settle the issue.
He's been picked up. He's been bitten, but not how you think.
Why don't you stay here? If you can come up with something that holds up better, I'd be delighted to hear it.
He helped out on weekends, training. I was glad of it, to be honest. For a priest, he was in pretty good shape.
What about Gary?
What about him?
Well, was he any good at games?
Yeah. You gonna make out there was something between him and Downey now?
You think it's out of the question?
I'm just getting really bored of this. You wanna work with kids and suddenly you're a pervert. Downey was all right.
Yeah, well, they fell out over something.
What's wrong with drugs? Maybe it had nothing to do with Downey. Maybe he was just in the wrong place at the wrong time. Speaking of which.
Thank you.
What is it?
Spinal fluid. If it is meningitis, this is where it'll show up.
Michael got you worried, has he?
These are video frames. Why aren't his?
Paedophiles like to send stuff down the net. It's safer than the post.
Have you checked his phone records?
Yeah, it doesn't look like he downloaded any of that himself.
So there's nothing to connect this to Father Downey, apart from a turning up in his house?
No, nothing at all. Apart from the fact that the kid in the pictures is the kid that knifed him.
But no pictures of Downey? Was the video recorded in Downey's flat?
No.
So, someone else may have recorded it. We need to find out who.
Sorry, we need to. Since when are we the Vice Squad?
You haven't established Downey was a pedophile.
Well, let's say I made a start.
None of this could have been planted.
Who by?
I thought the enemy didn't like churches. It's why we've got Gary banged up, isn't it? You can't have it both ways.
I remind you again, not everyone who works for them is infected. Has Gary made any accusations?
No, he hasn't said anything yet. It's not unusual.
Okay, fine. There's two ways of looking at this. One, we've got a boy, he's abused. Yep, by a priest. He gets too much, he pulls a knife. The other guys hear about it. Understandably, they show a post-traumatic reaction. Are you with me so far? Thank you. Option two, we've got what? Nothing. Has Angie found any marks on those boys?
No, but in my opinion, they are infected.
Well, how if they haven't been bitten?
That is the question.
Those kids should be back with their parents.
I agree. If we keep them overnight, we'll draw the media. If we release them, we can stick to the meningitis line. But Gary stays. He's the worst infected.
Fine. I want some corroboration on Downey's sexual proclivities before I swallow this line.
Fine, who shall I ask? His bishop?
No, you just stop making lazy connections between priests and pedophiles. You say he didn't download this filth himself. Find out who did.
This is where he dumped the jacket and tie.
What about the mothers that saw him? Didn't they hear any dog attack?
Nope, neither did any of the locals. We've combed the whole park and there's no sign of blood, so it didn't happen here. Are we chasing paedophiles or dogs?
Both.
You think he left the park with someone?
Uh-huh. Someone who didn't want us poking around his place.
You think he knew?
Well, either he knew him or he knew what he wanted. How many of the locals have we got earmarked?
With dogs, hundreds. But cross-reference those with paedophiles. We could be talking.
Do you feel able to answer a few questions now?
I want to go home.
I think you know that's not possible. Do you remember what you did? If you talk to us here, we might be able to help you with things later on. Why did you attack Father Downey? Did he hurt you?
He makes me sick.
Why?
I'm not talking to him.
I just came to say hello.
Get him out.
Do I make you sick too? What is it about me?
Please, make him go away.
Who hurt you, Gary?
That's enough.
I think so.
You okay? You're okay, he's gone now. He's gone now. You're fine. I didn't recognize you.
Well, you haven't aged a bit.
No, you look great.
What can I get you?
A glass of red.
Having second thoughts about your diagnosis?
I can see them affecting a single child if there's a parent they're trying to get to, but not a whole school.
Maybe that's exactly what they are planning. Mass infection. We don't know how many of them are out there, but it's hundreds, not thousands. There's no way they can infect us all by the traditional method, and they can't take control unless the majority are subjugated.
But infection has always been a byproduct of the feeding process. How can they infect without penetration?
Biological warfare. You isolated them. Active ingredient in garlic. What's it called?
Allison.
Perhaps they're just returning the favour.
Would you like to come back for something to eat?
That sounds ideal. Then you can give me my results.
Are you still with Ensis, or
have you moved on?
Sideways. And you're qualified, I hear.
Congratulations. Michael told you.
Well, I assume that's why you're here.
Yeah, well, we've sort of lost contact. Has he mentioned me at all?
Endlessly. I was sorry to hear about Jack.
Right, so you know what's going on then?
It must have been very hard on you. It was on Michael, too. It took a while for him to come to terms with it. I think at first he thought there was something else going on. Luckily, he managed to get it out of his system. That kind of thing can get obsessive if you're not careful.
He's told you everything then? Is that why he disappeared too? To get away from me?
I don't know. Are you harassing him?
I just want somebody to be straight with me.
Well, you've come to the right person. Leave him alone, Kirsty.
You're not going to give me a number then?
I don't think that's up to me.
You could give him a message.
Sorry.
No, you haven't changed. You still think I'm a waste of space.
Well, I don't know where you get that from.
You're not even going to tell him you saw me, are you?
I honestly can't see the point.
No? Well, you tell him I'm not on my own anymore. And I don't need his help.
Kirsty.
Yeah, I'm back home. I didn't get a thing out of her. It's a total waste of time. She is seeing him though. Maybe they're back together.
Look, actually, Kirsty, can I call you back? Yeah, look, another thing. I don't want to freak you, but can you not ring me from your home phone in future? Look, I know it's probably bollocks. Yeah. Look, anyway, I'll call you back. Yeah. Okay. What can I do for you?
Non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. That's a type of leukemia, isn't it?
It's in the lymphatic system.
But cancer. What are my chances?
Please. This is the start of diagnosis, not the end. You have low-grade lymphoma. We've yet to stage it. There's a lot of work to do before we start throwing around statistics.
She must be freezing.
She's punishing me. I wouldn't let her practice at the leisure centre. Not after dark. So the team dropped her. She's just ramming the point home, bless her. Apparently I'm getting a reputation as an antisocial parent. Don't change the subject.
Oh, low grade sounds good. It's not good.
It's slow growing.
And incurable.
It is treatable. People have gone into remission indefinitely.
What are the mortality rates?
That's meaningless.
Science is meaningless.
Statistics are other people, not you.
Oh. Let's have a look at you.
Hi!
Come and say hello properly.
I wonder where she gets it from.
This guy was interviewed at 3:15 once before in 85. Nothing since. A couple of trips to Thailand.
See what I mean? He wouldn't say boo to a goose, would you, Maxie? Well, it's not strictly true. He nearly had a duck last spring, and I wouldn't want to give a false character statement. No, he's no angel, quite a handful. He'd never take a piece out of anyone, would you, Maxie? And he loves boys.
Yeah. That makes two of you.
Listen, I've been polite to you a lot. I was polite to the police when they come round. I didn't go running screaming for some lawyer. I'm cooperating. So why are you digging up ancient history?
Because it's not that ancient, is it, Colin? You were trolling the park this afternoon.
Did he say that? Did he say he'd been here?
He hasn't said anything yet.
Oh, you're welcome to search the place if you want.
I don't think we need to waste our time with that. It would be a waste of time, wouldn't it? You've had all day.
Well, if you haven't got any evidence and you haven't got any witnesses, what are you doing wasting my time? I've got things to do. Oh, and by the way, who's your boss?
Now, you listen to me. Now, you listen good. We're not cops. We don't answer to cops. We do exactly what we like. Now, he was here, wasn't he? No, no, forget him. He's with me. Now, you ask him a question. I'm just getting started.
I didn't touch him.
Thank you. Your witness.
Do you know where this is? Do you know him?
Oh, he's from the school, isn't he? What?
You share any hobbies? Gary?
I never met him, and I never met Gary until today. I didn't drag him here. He knew what he was doing.
So what do you know about Father Downey?
Well, he has something to do with the soccer team. I used to take videos.
Are they here?
No, I burnt them. They're not what you're thinking. They're videos of soccer games. No harm in that, is there?
So no one ever challenged you?
Well, I coach the under-15s down the sports centre. I do talent spotting.
So, you gave one of these videos to Father Downey?
No.
Who?
I'm not grass. You can do what you like. I'm not an animal.
Well, you know, he's going to have to be destroyed. Well, at least that's what the law says. But as we've been reminded, we don't have to get involved with the law. Necessarily.
Maxie never did that to anyone before. I know he was only a kid, but there was something strange about him. I've only ever seen him like that once before. If I were to give you a name...
No ifs.
He's local. He's not like me. I never forced myself on anyone. Anyone that I ever went with was... No. Well, this guy. Maxie was the same way with him as he was with that kid. Except that he was a bit more scared.
His name?
Oliver. I hardly knew him. He didn't used to go out much in the daytime. He had some sort of skin allergy. He looked like death warmed up. God knows how I used to pick anyone up.
Yeah, all right, thank you. Just give us an address. happened to his face?
Skin grafts.
They said he couldn't go out in daylight. Something about an allergy. Well, it sounded like bollocks.
It's called xeroderma pigmentosum, XP. It's not an allergy, it's a genetic disease. It prevents the body from repairing DNA damage from UV. Even the most minimal exposure to daylight causes skin cancers.
Sounds like our version of what they've got.
Which may have been why they were interested in him. May also have influenced his sexual preferences. He hasn't exactly had a normal upbringing. Into care at two, his parents couldn't cope. Isolated from children his own age. Difficulty forming relationships with other
children. Stop it. You're breaking my heart. How does this tie in with what happened to the kids? Did he infect them or not?
Now that he's stabilized, I can run some tests. When he regains consciousness, we can ask him. You're going home.
Suspended. Fine.
Just home.
When are you going to move in? You haven't done a thing.
I've been busy.
Well, you look terrible. You'll never guess who I bumped into yesterday.
This is what we isolated in Gary's spinal fluid. It's a new strain of meningitis, a variation of meningococcal type C.
Meningitis? Not code 5?
That's the variation. They've altered the meningitis bacteria to carry code 5 infection. Normally, they infect through their own saliva, but these bacteria are transmitted human to human simply by close contact. That's the only way they can manufacture a Code 5 epidemic. By making us carriers. All they needed was a subject to incubate their new bacteria.
Why'd they choose a kid?
They didn't. It was Oliver. He's our patient zero. His inability to metabolize UV made him the ideal guinea pig. Our closest relative to Genus Code 5.
Except he couldn't control himself and broke quarantine. Is there a cure for Gary?
The laser treatment only works where there's a wound, but I think I can produce an anti-serum based on Oliver's spinal fluid. Gary should recover.
What about after? He'll have to stand trial.
Oh. They framed Father Downey to put us off. Let's go with that.
Fit Downey up as a paedophile.
He's gone. Gary has the rest of his life ahead of him.
She's not the mouse I knew. I can see what you mean now.
Oh, yeah? What do I mean?
I mean I can see why you like her. She's a real person. I don't think she's going to give up.
She's going to have to.
She's got someone helping her. She didn't say who, but I took the liberty of lifting her phone records. Save you the trouble. He's a journalist. Jacob Keenout. He wrote a book on missing persons. He's quite a pain in the ass by all accounts. He's good. I got the impression they're quite close.
She gave you that impression, did she?
No, I made that last bit up. Anyhow, I thought you should know. Well, I hope I'm not going to have any other unexpected visitors chasing after you. I'm not your secretary.
Don't worry about it. I'm on the way out. Thank Christ.
I had no choice.
There's always a choice. They can't force you to do what you don't want.
No, they force you to do what you do want. They're very big on free will.
They gave you a boy. A boy who wouldn't grow up. You'd never tell his parents, a boy with no soul and humanity you thought you could abuse with a clear conscience. What went wrong?
I couldn't.
Of course not, because he wasn't a child. Probably been around longer than you have, whatever his body looks like. That doesn't work for you, does it? And of course you couldn't relive the experience on video. Bit of a disaster, really. So you went back to boys like Gary. No matter you were contagious.
What's the difference? They're taking over one way or another.
And you have no qualms about that? Humanity?
I missed out on humanity. Haven't you heard?
Where did you go for this experiment?
The boy brought the chemicals.
Does he have a name?
They'll find out what you want.
Well, so that's your considered verdict, is it? After 12 hours?
I've compared your and Vaughn's version, and there's no case to answer. One in a million circumstance.
Right, so that's it, is it? That's your inquiry. Two Hail Marys and don't shoot any more civilians.
You can wear a hair shirt if it makes you feel better.
So what do I have to do to get fired around here?
Oh, you won't need to. The way you're going, you're looking at early retirement. The fact that he turned out to be human is not the scary part. You pumped two bullets into his chest and still managed to miss his heart. If he was a leech, you'd be dead.
You'd be happier if I had killed him.
Happy doesn't come into it. If you must know, I happen to rate you. I think you've got a lot of potential.
Mm-hmm.
If you can keep yourself alive, that is.
Great, so a couple of years and I'll be just like you. Brilliant.
Oliver and I are related, you know? Do you know that sun exposure is implicated in my condition? It's amazing what you can pick up on the net. Couldn't find those statistics you don't want me to see. But the latest thinking is that UV is a potential trigger for non-Hodgkin's lymphoma. Must have been that 18 months out in Melbourne. The sun giveth and the sun taketh away.
I'm not going to let you die.
I have no plans in that direction.
Okay, it's a reason, but don't ever do it to me again.
Yeah, I promise. It smells good. Hmm.
Do you really think my phone's tapped?
Uh-huh. Almost definitely.
But we don't know anything.
Yet.
This, source of yours, did he say anything about Jack?
They think he might have found something out about this squad.
Death squad?
Mm-hmm.
Michael?
He's up to his neck in it.
Well, we've got to go to the police now, surely.
No, not yet, no.
What can we do? I mean, what can I do? I can't even cook, apparently.
Look, you know Michael. You're crucial. Do you want me to go?
It's late.
Okay.
I like you. It's just too soon.
It's okay.